beseech thee, that we, being holpen by the Virgin Mary, his mother, may attain unto the joys of everlasting life, through the same Christ our Lord. Amen. Alleluia, Christ is risen.
The Lord is risen indeed. Alleluia.
Almighty God, unto whom all hearts are open, all desires known, and from whom no secrets are hid, cleanse the thoughts of our hearts by the inspiration of thy Holy Spirit, that we may perfectly love thee and worthily magnify thy holy name, through Christ our Lord. Amen. Kyrie eleison.
Kyrie eleison.
Kyrie eleison.
Christe eleison.
Christe eleison.
Christe eleison.
Kyrie eleison. Glory be to God on high, and on earth peace, goodwill towards men. We praise thee, we bless thee, we worship thee, we glorify thee, we give thanks to thee for thy great glory. O Lord God, heavenly King, God the Father Almighty, O Lord, the only begotten Son, Jesus Christ, O Lord God, Lamb of God, Son of the Father, that takest away the sins of the world, have mercy upon us. Thou that takest away the sins of the world, receive our prayer. Thou that sittest at the right hand of God the Father, have mercy upon us. For thou only art holy, thou only art the Lord, thou only, O Christ, with the Holy Ghost, art most high in the glory of God the Father. Amen. The Lord be with you.
And with thy spirit.
Let us pray. O God, who by the waters of baptism hast renewed those who believe in thee, come to the help of those who have been reborn in Christ, that they may overcome the wiles of the devil and continue faithful to the gifts of grace that they have received from thee. Through Jesus Christ our Lord, who liveth and reigneth with thee and the Holy Spirit, one God, for ever and ever. Amen.
A reading from the Acts of the Apostles. Now the whole group of those who believed were of one heart and soul, and no one claimed private ownership of any possessions, but everything they owned was held in common. With great power, the apostles gave their testimony to the resurrection of the Lord Jesus, and great grace was upon them all. There was not a needy person among them, for as many as owned land or houses sold them and brought the proceeds of what was sold. They laid it at the apostles' feet, and it was distributed to each as any had need. There was a Levite, a native of Cyprus, Joseph, to whom the apostles gave the name Barnabas, which means son of encouragement. He sold a field that belonged to him, then brought the money and laid it at the apostles' feet. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
I will say together Psalm 93. The Lord is King.
He has put on splendid apparel.
The Lord has put on his apparel and girded himself with strength.
He has made the whole world so short that it cannot be moved. Ever since the world began, your throne has been established. You are from everlasting. The waters have lifted up the Lord. The waters have lifted up their voice. The waters have lifted up their pounding wings. Mightier than the sound of many waters. Mightier than the breakers of the sea. Mightier is the Lord who dwells on high. Your testimonies are very sure, and holiness adorns your house, O Lord, forever and forevermore.
Alleluia.
Alleluia.
If then you have been raised with Christ, seek the things that are above, where Christ is, seated at the right hand of God.
Alleluia. The Lord be with you.
And with thy spirit.
The Holy Gospel of our Lord Jesus Christ according to John.
Glory be to thee, O Lord.
Jesus said to Nicodemus, "Do not be astonished that I said to you, you must be born from above. The wind blows where it chooses, and you hear the sound of it, but you do not know where it comes from or where it goes. So it is with everyone who is born of the Spirit." Nicodemus said to him, "How can these things be?" Jesus answered him, "Are you a teacher of Israel, and yet you do not understand these things? Very truly I tell you, we speak of what we know and testify to what we have seen, yet you do not receive our testimony. If I have told you about earthly things and you do not believe, how can you believe if I tell you about heavenly things? No one has ascended into heaven except the one who descended from heaven, the Son of Man. And just as Moses lifted up the serpent in the wilderness, so must the Son of Man be lifted up, that whoever believes in him may have eternal life." The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, O Christ.
Father, we pray for thy holy Catholic Church,
that we all may be one.
Grant that every member of the Church may truly and humbly serve thee.
That thy name may be glorified by all people.
We pray for all bishops, priests, and deacons,
that they may be faithful ministers of thy word and sacraments.
We pray for all who govern and hold authority in the nations of the world,
that there may be justice and peace on the earth.
Give us grace to do thy will in all that we undertake,
that our works may find favor in thy sight.
For those who have asked for our prayers, for Joseph, Anita, Grant, Barbara, Jean, Marie, Frank, Lydia, William, Laura, James, Philippa, Becca, Susan, Charles, Joan, Rebecca, Brendan, Jack, Charlotte, William, Michael, and for Eleanor and Ed. Have compassion on those who suffer from any grief or trouble,
that they may be delivered from their distress.
For the souls of the faithful departed, today for Daphne and for James, give to the departed eternal rest.
Let light perpetual shine upon them.
We praise thee for thy saints who have entered into joy.
May we also come to share in thy heavenly kingdom.
Let us pray for our own needs and for those of others. We pray for Stephen on his birthday. Lord, hear the prayers of thy people, and what we have asked faithfully, grant that we may obtain effectually, to the glory of thy name, through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. The peace of the Lord be always with you.
And with thy spirit.
Offer to God a sacrifice of thanksgiving, and make good thy vows unto the Most High. divine blood of human hands, it will become a spiritual drink.
Blessed be God forever.
Pray, my brothers and sisters, that this, my sacrifice and yours, may be acceptable to God, the Father Almighty.
May the Lord
receive
the sacrifice
at thy
hands,
for the praise and glory of his name, for our benefit and that of all his holy church.
The Lord be with you.
And with our spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to
the Lord.
Let us give thanks unto our Lord God.
It is meet and right so to do.
It is very meet, right, and our bounden duty to glorify thee, O Father, and to give thanks unto thee. For thou alone art God, living and true, dwelling in light inaccessible, from before time and forever. Fountain of life and source of all goodness, thou hast made all things, and didst fill them with thy blessing, creating them to rejoice in the splendor of thy radiance. Countless throngs of angels stand before thee to serve thee night and day, and beholding the glory of thy presence, they offer thee unceasing praise. Joining with them and giving voice to every creature under heaven, we praise thee and glorify thy name, saying, Holy, 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 Lord God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of thy glory. Glory be to thee, O Lord most high. Blessed is he that cometh in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. We acclaim thee, Holy Lord, glorious in power, whose mighty works reveal thy wisdom and love. Thou hast formed us in thy own image, giving the whole world into our care, that in obedience to thee, our Maker, we might rule and serve all thy creatures. When our disobedience took us far from thee, thou didst not abandon us to the power of death, but in thy mercy thou didst come to our help, that in seeking thee we might find thee. Again and again thou didst call us into covenant with thee, and through the prophets thou didst teach us to hope for salvation. Thou didst so love the world, O Father, that in the fullness of time thou didst send thine only begotten Son to be our Saviour. Incarnate by the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, he lived as one of us, yet without sin. To the poor he proclaimed the good news of salvation, to prisoners freedom, to the sorrowful joy. That thy purpose might be fulfilled, he gave himself up unto death, and rising from the grave he destroyed death, and made the whole creation new. And that we might live no longer unto ourselves, but unto him who died for us and rose again, he sent the Holy Spirit, his own first gift for those who believe, to complete his work in the world, bringing to fulfillment the sanctification of all. When the hour had come for him to be glorified by thee, his heavenly Father, having loved his own who were in the world, he loved them to the end. At supper with them he took bread, and when he had given thanks to thee, he broke it, and gave it to his disciples, and said, Take, eat. This is my body, which is given for you. Do this for the remembrance of me. Likewise, after supper, he took the cup, and when he had given thanks, he gave it to them and said, Drink ye all of this, for this is my blood of the new covenant, which he shed for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this as oft as ye shall drink it for the remembrance of me.
Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us
God of peace, who brought aid from the dead our Lord Jesus Christ, the great shepherd of the sheep, through the blood of the everlasting covenant, make you perfect in every good work to do his will, working in you that which is well pleasing in his sight. And the blessing of God Almighty, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Ghost, be upon you and remain with you always.
Amen.
Go in peace to love and serve the Lord. Alleluia, alleluia.
Thanks be to God.
Alleluia, alleluia.